Hello, and thank you for joining me today for a very informative webinar presented by S&P Global and ACP. I'm your host, Megan Launder, Vice President of Corporate Relations. This session will offer a unique look into leveraging veteran skills and technology careers and provide a roadmap for navigating the IT sector post-military life. With me today, I have Susy Rim, a veteran and process engineering manager. Susy will share her inspiring transition story into the IT sector. I also have with me Abdul Rauf, Senior Software Development Manager, who will discuss S&P Global's dynamic IT culture and growth opportunities. First, we will go through some introductions and some pre-generated questions for Susy and Abdul, and then we'll get to audience questions at the end. But we do encourage the audience to please drop the questions in the chat as we go along so we have time to get to them at the end. All right, let's start with an introduction. Susy, go ahead.
Hi, everyone. I'm a veteran who served 8 years in the United States Army as a signal officer. I am actually also an ACP alum. I transitioned back in 2017 to a corporate career at IT as an IT risk consultant, working in information security advisory and IT audit. Now I'm working as a process engineering manager, which really is sort of that cross-section of bringing together that IT risk and business operations, supporting the enterprise solutions segment at S&P.
Great. Thanks, Susy. And we appreciate that you're alum. Thank you for going through the program. Abdul?
Yeah. Okay. Hi, everyone. I'm Abdul, working as a senior manager software development in S&P Global. I have almost 20 years experience in the software industry. Throughout my career, if you can split it down, I mostly work with the software houses, like the 15 years in the medical health sectors. Mostly work with the New Zealand Ministry, Australia, South Africa, Ireland, and Doha, Qatar. Throughout my careers, actually, so much diversity in the context of integrations and to promote something new culture as well. So during my whole career, I work in the .NET technologies. In the S&P Global, actually, I'm managing a couple of people as well, along with the technical development stuff. And with the context of mentoring sessions, if you think like I mentor like six different mentees from under the umbrella of ACP. Also, I'm working with the STEM, science, technology, engineering, math in the context of with the New York Science Academy with the 4 or 5 years as well. Similarly, actually in the context of mentee, I'm working with a mentor as a with MWM Million Women's Mentorships, like the empowerment of the women to so they can transform their careers towards the technical departments. Yeah, that's a quick intro.
That's a very impressive and fascinating background. I know our military community will learn a lot from you today. I'm very excited. Susy, let's dive a little deeper into your transition experience. Can you describe your transition from military life to a role in IT? How did your service prepare you for this change?
Yeah, thanks so much, Megan. So, as I mentioned, I did actually start my career in the field a little bit, mostly working in communications and IT, and a range of my experience really goes from technical to non-technical management in the field. And even with that foundational background, which may or may not be similar to some of the veterans listening today, even with that, I think there was a lot of trepidation when I was going through the transition of whether I wanted to stay in the technology field, and I felt a little overwhelmed by everything that was out there. I'll talk a little bit about the resources here in a little bit, but ultimately all my preparation work, networking, and shopping around sort of led me to take a position with Ernst & Young, which is a big accounting firm, as an IT risk consultant focused on information security advisory. And I know that sounds complicated, but entering the risk and compliance field, I actually found that it fit really well with my military background and understanding and managing risk. I think that that's something that we do in the military on a daily basis, regardless of what type of role or position that you might be serving in currently. So when I first entered the workforce, I was further surprised by the fact that most of the colleagues that I was working with in the field had business or finance related backgrounds, as opposed to the IT education and training that you would really see in the more traditional IT tracks, such as network infrastructure administration or software development like Abdul. However, that's not really to say that technical knowledge and skills aren't necessary. They absolutely are crucial to growth and progression in the field. For example, since leaving the Army and working specifically and deeper, growing my expertise in information security, I earned my Certified Information Systems Security Professional certification, and that's definitely one of the things that will continue on as you find your way into the corporate sector, especially in IT. A lot of that work is already very structured, and you can follow, hey, if I want to go down this path, these are the certifications, this is the knowledge, this is the skills that I need to be able to develop. So after some time doing information and cybersecurity, I actually decided to go back to school. For me, because I already had a little bit of that technology background, I was interested in getting more into the understanding of business strategy, organizational development, and human resources. And since starting with S&P, I've had the opportunity to take on one of my dream roles, developing a process management program, which I see as really bringing about the integration of business strategy and operations with technology and people to create process excellence. So the current program that I'm running is focused on strategic alignment, risk management, and automation and industrialization, which is really well aligned with my background and the skills that I brought over from the military. So in essence, I think that the most important takeaway from my story that I'd like to share is that IT has become just so ubiquitous across the board to operations and organizations. And this evolution has really brought us from single form technology departments to integration of technology in every aspect of the business. And thus, the field of technology itself continues to grow in different directions, and there's so many opportunities, both traditional and non-traditional, as well as technical to non-technical, for you to look into. So just as we think about it, right, maybe we have some preconceived notions or stereotypes about the IT field, the same is for most people thinking about veterans or service members, right? Some cliche about camo and mud and leaves, right? And I'm sure that most veterans have checked that box, sure, but we know that there's a lot more diversity and complexity when we start talking about the difference between services, branches, and MOSs, and unit types. Even between different unit types, you might be doing something completely different, even within the same MOS skill. So I'd like to share that maybe you need to take on that type of a perspective when you're thinking about the IT field, and don't be afraid to dive in, learn more, and really see about those opportunities that may fit well with your skills more so than you're thinking. And I think that that's really important, because when we're talking about those skill sets that we're bringing over from the military as veterans, I absolutely believe that adaptability and flexibility is one of the most crucial and important skills that we bring over. That ability to change gears and to really drive towards mission accomplishment, regardless of what the mission might be or the obstacles that stand in the way. I can't state enough how important that skill is and how useful it is in the corporate sector. I think that the other ones that probably came to the forefront when I started thinking about what I brought is a lot of that problem solving skills, right? We have to think on our feet. We have to think on a time crunch. We have to make decisions quickly. I think that really gave me a leg up, and it's a skill that would make you successful in IT. As long as you're willing to solve the problem or figure it out, you'll get IT. And lastly, you just need to pair that with just a learning and willingness to train and grow, which I think is a staple of how the military operates, right? At every level, there's a school. At every level, there's something else to be learned. And there's continuous growth. And I think that IT is one of those sectors where that's inherently built in, so you can climb that ladder.
Right. Yeah, I think there's a stigma there that people don't realize how involved IT is and how many layers there are. So thank you so much for highlighting that and also highlighting specific military skills that can be transferred over to IT, the IT sector. That was very informative. Thank you, Susy.
Yeah.
What about resources? What are some of the most useful resources you would say that helped you and that you identified today?
Yes. And, you know, as I stated earlier, I am an ACP alum myself, and I'm not I'm not only advertising because this is an ACP event, but in all honesty, ACP was the core of my transition plan. And through the ACP program and mentorship, I was able to really plan out and get after this transition in a way that made me a lot more comfortable than I felt when I was first thinking about making that move. So I began working with my I probably started working on my separation about a year prior, started planning it out, and really started diving in about 8 months out, started putting boots on the ground, meeting with my mentor, Cheryl, who I can't thank enough. Mm-hmm. She taught me everything from how to address emails to ma'am is okay once, and then you have to drop it. She taught me a lot about workplace culture, helping me with my resume, all the way to helping me land informational interviews and opportunities to network with people across the IT sphere. And it was actually ultimately a network connection that I made through Cheryl, which led me to meet a veteran at EY who ended up referring me to my first corporate position. So the program works.
That's so great to hear. We love to hear that. That he was able to provide you with that base and that kickstart to your transition. Any other resources that you've identified?
Absolutely. I think that one strategy that I did use that I would recommend to people is that there are a lot of companies out there that actually are committed to hiring veterans and have programs or have stood up recruiting sections that work with veterans. And targeting those companies and those opportunities really gave me an opportunity to get out there and attend different sessions and attend different hiring events and network with different people, and it made me a lot more comfortable than going in cold and not necessarily having that veteran line in. A lot, you know, if I fumble around here and there with a little bit of learning the corporate lingo, they're willing to work with you. And I think that lastly, but most importantly, when it comes to IT, regardless of what track or sector that you're looking to get into, I believe that certifications are really the best way to prepare and start and continue to support a career in the IT field. And, you know, there are certainly pros and cons on certifications, but in my opinion, it does largely favor veterans, a structured way to explore the IT field, ability to learn and complete via self-study or courses, and can sometimes be more meaningful than getting a general degree for those not looking to go back to school. So a program specifically that I use is called the Danielo Institute for Veterans and Military Families in partnership with Syracuse University. And on there, you can actually go through and once you apply to the program, they offer these courses for IT ranging from all different types of technical skills to business management skills and human resources skills. I myself used it for the PMP, project management professional. Mm-hmm. But really this program has the structured nature and options for self-paced study or these days, in-person classes at select military institutions are great, and the courses are absolutely free, and certifications are paid for once you complete those courses. And sometimes those vouchers can be hundreds of dollars. So yeah, definitely worth a look.
Great information and advice. Thanks, Susy. Yeah. Abdul, we're going to shift to you. As a mentor and leader, what aspects of S&P Global's culture do you think resonate most with veterans?
Okay. In my view, the core principle of S&P Global, like integrity, excellence, and the teamwork, are exactly the consistent with the values of the military services. Like, the culture of S&P is one of the respect and appreciation for everyone. It encourages collaboration and professional development at every level. The organization supports various programs such as the American Corporate Partner initiatives that offers mentorship opportunity. And just like if you join the S&P, we already have another bunch of programs like Essential Tech Education Program, which focus on the STEM education as well. Through our commitment to the diversity and inclusion, we create an environment where everyone feels valued and included in the diverse fabric of the organizations. So within our current organizations, we are actually highly supportive in the context of diversity. Similarly, actually, we are in the context of professional and career growth. If we move on to the next stage, I will explain like how we are working within the organization as a mentor and mentee as well. It's not only like we are working with the outside of the organization, but within the inside of the organization, we're grooming each other, we're working with each other, we are defining the different pathways so that anyone can upskill in, you know, in nowadays, actually, you know, like it's a very, very important for us to create the new pathways so everyone can need to get upskills according to their fields or department-wise. So the best thing which come into my mind is actually the integrity, the excellence, and the teamwork. It's the same thing with, from where we both are actually 100% sync.
That's great. Do you have any other examples of some career growth in S&P?
In the context of, if you're asking like how the career growth is actually definitely like, first of all, actually, we really need to meet, we set the stage bars, just like in the military services, like we, based on the rank, there are different responsibilities are there, right? So we really need to be up to the mark to hold that. We are continuously working within our each department, what is actually required, what we are actually looking for. For example, if someone newly joined us, like it's not like we are going to directly he or she need to be start the development in any platforms, right? We provide onboarding training might be up to 3 months, just like the military services, like they need to be get equipped themselves and then they can move to the fields, right? Similarly, actually, over here, like they need to be built on, first of all, like how they need to get the handies with the technology stuff. They need to understand what kind of the different platforms are there, what kind of roles are there, how the teams are get communicated or sharing information with each other. Like what is the actually the level of communication and making so much easy that everyone can get educated and groom himself or herself.
Great to hear. That's great that S&P really focuses on growing and developing its workforce. That's especially important for our veterans, as you probably have realized. So for both of you, in what ways, Susy, you've already touched on this, but maybe you have some more examples. In what ways do you see veteran skills as uniquely beneficial in the IT sector, especially S&P Global? We can start with Abdul or Susy, whoever wants to go first.
Like it can be in any area. Like you cannot say like one. There are so many departments, like business analysts, system analysts, software development, scrum masters, quality assurance, purely data analyst, machine learning analyst. Like AI is actually already there. Prompt engineers are there. So cloud engineers are there. Automation process are there. So there are huge number of different paths is available within the S&P. If you are actually purely asking like for any mentee, what we do or myself do when I started working with any mentee, we sit down together. First of all, we try to remove the gap between us. We create such environment, they feel so much easy. They can share even anything with me. And then actually we can draft a roadmap like how we can gradually building our towards the target. Like our target might be the like master degree, our target might be the software engineer. Our target is actually might be, we need to be a cloud engineer, right? In that direction, these all are the different departments actually need to get some kind of hands-on experience on the different technologies. So we define that, we list down, we search down them, we work on that, and we continuously moving towards the progress.
Great. And just want to remind the audience, please drop any questions you have in the chat as we get closer to concluding. Susy, anything you want to add there?
Yeah, I know. I talked about adaptability earlier, and like I said, I can't say enough how important that skill is in giving you a leg up. But also, in addition to that, I think that Abdul answered it earlier, but teamwork was one of the things mentioned. I absolutely believe teamwork is probably one of the ways that we say it, but honestly, at the end of the day, it's about the ability to partner with and very simply put, play nice with others, right? Yeah. And that ability to come in and really sync with different people and different personality types. And I think that in some ways, we sort of have that experience already in the military with our continuous move. There's always a new unit to join, new people to learn about, and new people to work with. So I think that that's definitely helpful. And also from a customer service perspective, IT tends to be a support function most of the time. And so you really have to think about, it's very rare that IT is operating individually and on its own. It's very much integrated into the fabric of different business operations. So there's always going to be some level of teamwork going on. And like I said earlier, I think that that dedication to continuous growth and learning is absolutely well suited for the IT sector.
You both have already touched on this, but anything else to add in regards to how S&P Global assists in keeping the skills of veterans current in the rapidly evolving field of technology? Abdul, I know you, do you have any other specifics that you want to add there?
See, S&P Global already offers numerous opportunities for the professional development and career development within its IT department. Like, for example, if you are starting with the software developers, individuals have the potential to progress in more senior roles as well, right? Including senior software developer, technical leads, and people are technical managers as well. To facilitate the professional development of its employees, S&P Global provide access to a variety of training programs, workshops, conferences as well, designed to enhance the technical skills and knowledge, right? Similarly, additionally, the company encourage employee to pursue certifications relevant to their roles, which I previously explained as well by the Susy. S&P Global also promotes internal mobility. Like, it's a wonderful thing, which I really want to share. Like, you can move from one department to another department. You think like when you join like the software development departments and you think like, I'm not good for here, I need to move on the system analyst or business analyst within the organization. It's a wonderful way, like you can move from one department to another department, right? Enabling its workforce to explore innovative teams and projects as well, and to broaden their expertise as well. Furthermore, like S&P also, like, you know, as you already know, offers mentorship program and encourage its workforce to participate in the industry events and communities as well, right? So that we can build the people and we can move on to the next initiative. These initiatives actually foster a culture of continuously learning and growth, empowering IT professional to remain ahead in their careers. So if you are actually continuously on the right track, on the right path, you are actually continuously growing into multiple, creating opportunity by yourselves, right? So by enabling these different variety of paths, you can move on to the next stage. Right?
Susy, any thoughts there?
Yes. One of the things that we might have mentioned very quickly passed over, but we do have a couple of technology-specific programs here, for one being Code Platoon that I know Abdul mentioned earlier, but this is a Valor Partner program that's really about transforming veterans and military spouses into skilled software developers. And then another program that S&P actually works with is called Empower, which is about creating pipelines for the digital workforce by providing technical training and upskilling for underserved learners and communities or populations. And veterans have the ability to get on there, apply, and also look at taking some training. So these are some alternatives, and really there's lots of programs out there like we've mentioned so far, and there are so many out there that are targeted specifically for veterans. So do take the time to do a little bit of that research and see what's out there and what's the best fit for you.
So I just want to add more few cents on that. Like as Susy explained it, like ACP is actually like you need to groom yourself in all direction. If I can elaborate like these three different program which is being offered by S&P, ACP is actually you can groom by your LinkedIn profile, your CVs as well, your communication skills as well. Like you need to be and get one step ahead to the different diversity cultures as well, right? But when you move to the Code Platoon, that is purely for the developers. Like they need to upskills in the in Java, in .NET, in cloud computing. They offer free a lot of 6 months courses. You can enroll anyone and you can learn on that. And similarly, she explained the Empower as well. That's another program which is offered by S&P. So you can enroll each of them and you can groom yourself very quickly within the 6 months or 8 months or 12 months. Right.
Yeah. For some of these programs, what is the average length of them? And can anyone at S&P, what are some of the requirements? Are there specific requirements for some of these programs, or do they take anyone that, or do they allow anyone to enter the programs that's interested?
For Code Platoon, it's already 1 year, similar with the ACPIR, it's 1 year as well. Empower, I am not 100% sure. So you know the duration? Like it's 6 months or 12 years, I don't exactly know the figures.
I think it depends on which part of the program that you sign up for. So I think it varies by program. Right now, yep.
Okay. And are there for Empower specifically, are there any requirements that are required to enter the program, parameters?
You should be need to the military services, either like anyone who they can want their from forces to the actually pure technical stuff. Then these are the three different programs, specifically the ACP and the Code Platoon, both of them.
Got it. Susy, you had mentioned some certifications earlier that you recommend. Let's say there's a veteran that's transitioning tomorrow. What would be your recommendation? Where should they start?
I think there's
so many certifications out there. I know it could be overwhelming for many. So it's probably especially overwhelming for a veteran that's just transitioning.
Yeah, absolutely. So I think that maybe some of the if you're coming into this with no IT background at all, then I think that I would recommend some of the more basic beginner courses. For example, when I talked about Onward to Opportunity earlier, actually, when you go to that list of course offerings, it'll specifically tell you what career track that it's aligned to, whether that be information security, cybersecurity, straight IT, or business management, or development, programming, right? So it actually lists it all out so that you can parse through and see what you're actually interested in pursuing, as well as the course level. So whether that's for beginner, advanced, and so forth. So for me specifically, talking about like information security, probably start talking about looking at the CompTIA certifications. such as like starting with A plus, network plus, security plus, things like that.
Great. Abdul, what about you? Do you have any recommendations for certifications from a software standpoint?
As she already explained, like we cannot directly jump toward the certification. You really need to go through. It's like information world. So you don't really need to. It won't much time to explore the diversity of different domains. Like, what is cybersecurity? What is software development? What is the cloud cloud architects? What they are working? What network security guys are doing? What the system analyst doing? What the business analyst doing? What is their jobs? What is their daily activity? Based on that, actually, which pathways you are following, you can move on to that direction very easily. I personally believe, like, by exploring these, you very quickly learn you need to build your resume, you need to get interactive, you need to be more easy in the context of communication with anyone. You should not be biased, or you should not be like, you should be very much relaxed. Like, you should need how to present your, first of all, the problems. If you don't explain yourself, then it's very difficult to assess, like, which area is the best for you. So best, like, if first of all you explain inner yourself, and then you can very easily decide, like, I need to move on this direction, it's good for me, and I can decide this certification. So I personally, like, start with the communication skills and building the relationship with the outer people, and then you can move on to the technology stuff. So, right.
That's a great path for you to give to everyone. I think that was very helpful. Thank you both. As we wrap up, I wanted to get some last minute thoughts from you both. I'll start with you, Susy. Any last words of encouragement or tips to provide to our audience?
So I think just to wrap everything up, I think the biggest message that I want to get across is the IT field is so large, and there's so many opportunities that a lot of veterans would do really well and find success in their corporate career by going this direction. And I encourage you all not to be intimidated by it, and spend some time researching and networking. I don't think that there's anything quite as effective as networking, and literally reaching out to people, and people are a lot more responsive and want to help a lot more than you would think. So don't be afraid to reach out. Don't be afraid to explore. And best of luck in your transitions.
Yeah. In my context, like, as she already explained, build your network. Like, as much as you have diversity in your network, you are actually going to blast in so much very quickly in all direction. Might be that is coming from first, like, variety of domains, like the medical health sector, the financial sectors. Similarly, like, might be there are other integrations, like with the ministries as well. Like, every ministry, they have their own different departments as well. IT is there everywhere. So you really need to understand, like, how you can best fit by yourself in this area, right? So for that, actually, just explore, build your network, reach out a variety of the people, and discuss with them, like, I want to pursue, this is my interest. Now our world is actually purely the artificial intelligence. It's clearly set the goals for you as well. If you're using the ChatGPT, you can very easily draft your roadmap for the whole year or for the next 6 months. And even you can define your daily activities as well. So you don't need to put much effort, except you just need to give them inputs, like, these are my daily habits, these are my resources, so I need to build my career in particular. This will give me the whole roadmap. It will give you the complete direction very easily over there, right? So just start. It's just like you need to be guessed. You just need one step as a first start. Right.
That's really great advice. Thank you both for joining us today. You both gave so many amazing tips to our transitioning veterans and also our active duty spouses that are looking for their next career. We're so grateful to have you both. And for those of you that are watching, please join me on Tuesday for another exciting webinar featuring ASML. They will provide helpful tips on how to jumpstart your civilian career. And if you're not already a mentor or mentee, we hope that you consider joining our mission and fill out an application today. Links have been dropped in the chat. And I know, Susy and Abdul, you've also provided some really helpful links as well that have been dropped in the chat. Please, everyone that's watching, utilize those. And Thank you all. Have a great day.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.